Ato ng sugda ng atong tulumanon karong buntaga, pinagi sa mubo nga pangaliya, humanana pabilintang magbarog for the singing of the Philippine National Anthem and Sugbu Hymn. Sa ngalan samahan, sa anak, sa Diyos Espiritu Santo. Amen. Ginoo, salamat sa imong makanunayong panalangin kanamo. Himo ang kiningamong pagabuhaton karong buntaga magmalampuson o makapahimuot kanimo. Kini among giampo pinagi ni Kristo imong anak. Sa ngalan samahan, sa anak, sa Espiritu Santo. Amen. Yaminaw be seated, makalingkod na ang tanan. Mayong buntag, aniya kita sa usa ka mahinungdanon kayong kalihukan dinhi sa Capitol Social Hall. Una sa tanan, akong ipaila ang atong kadakuan nga aniya karon dinhi, the first woman governor of Cebu, Gobernador Gwen Garcia. Kuy usab kanato ang atong mga Cebu Provincial Board members gikan sa ikaduhang distrito. Aniya si Board Member Jose Marie Salvador, Tata Salvador. Gikan sa ikaupat nga distrito, Board Member Rasi Franco. Gikan sa ikaunom nga distrito, Board Member Junki Uwano. Gikan sa ikapitong distrito, Board Member Christopher Dong Baricuatro. O Board Member Jerome Librando. Ang atong sangguniang Kabataan Federation President, Board Member Jericho Rubio. Ang atong kadakuan sa Cebu Provincial Police Office pinanguluhan ni Police Colonel Engelbert Soriano, Provincial Director. Atong kadakuan sa 53rd Engineering Brigade sa Philippine Army, niya sila si Lieutenant Colonel Efraim Kamaganakan o Colonel Jerry Borja, AFP Task Group, Cebu, Bohol, and Siquijor. Colonel Jerry Borja. Gikan sa Regional Community Defense Group 7, ARISCOM, Philippine Army, Colonel Edgar Mangabay. Gikan sa Visayan Electric Company Incorporated, Mark Kindika, AF, Assistant Vice President for Engineering Operations sa VECO. Gikan sa Cebu Electric Cooperative 1, CEPECO 1, General Manager Gritulio Crudua. CEPECO 2, General Manager Lowell Belsinia. CEPECO 3, General Manager Virgilio Fortich. Og ang ato mga linemen, gikan sa Beko og CEPECO, a big hand for them, ato mga linemen. Agig paghangop og pagdawat sa tanan, let us now listen to the welcome message from the Chairman, Committee on Peace and Order of the Cebu Provincial Board, Board Member Junki Owano.
Buhat ang pasultion, dili sulti ang pabuhaton, matud pa o gipamutud-an sa numero unong gobernador, sa numero unong probinsya sa tibuok nasod, ang atong pinalanggang Governor Gwen Garcia. Gov, may buntag. Akong mga kauban sa Junta Probinsya, ang atong Police Director sa Cebu Province, Police Colonel Engelbert Soriano, PD, Colonel Jerry Borja, Lieutenant Colonel Efraim Kamaganakan, Colonel Edgar Mangabay, Mark Kindika, AVP for Engineering Operations, VECO, Engineer Gitulio Crudua, General Manager, CEPECO 1, Engineer Luel Belsina, General Manager, CEPECO 2, Engineer Virgilio Fortich, General Manager, CEPECO 3, Guests, friends, ladies and gentlemen, pagbalik, may buntag. We're gathered here at this moment to give due recognition to the men and women who contributed much in our recovery from the tragedy that was Super Typhoon Odette. The destruction that left thousands of families in distress was overwhelming. Many thought it will take us several months of clearing debris before we could stand up once again. However, tungod sa dakong tabang sa abtik natong mga pulis ug military, paspas kaayo ang paghawan sa atong komunidad, which is the first vital step to our speedy recovery. Along with our police and military, we also hail today the swift action of our linemen, some of whom come from other places who are far away from their families to risk life and limb to help the people of our beloved province of Cebu. The Cebuanos are truly grateful to all of you. Kung mangutana magita karon sa kadaghanan sa mga Cebuanon, kahayag or ayuda, sigurado ko ang tubag, kahayag, pero mas daghan yung miingon kung pwede ang duha. Isip Chairman sa Committee of Public Safety, Peace and Order ug agig pagsanong sa taha sa Cebu Provincial Government, akong itunol kaninyo ang mainiton, mapasalamaton, masigarbuhong nga pagdawat kaninyong tanan sa atong gipahigayon nga incentive distribution karong buntaga. Once again, daghan kay salamat kaninyong tanan and welcome to today's ceremony. Salamat.
Daghan salamat, Board Member Junki Owano. Thank you. Nining kayo na mauna ang pagapodapod ceremonial turnover sa cash incentives ngadto sa atong mga linemen, Philippine National Police o Armed Forces of the Philippines. Atong gihangyo sila si Gobernador Gwen Garcia o tanang board members present to the stage for the ceremonial turnover of the cash incentives. And I'd like to remind our linemen, mga beneficiaries nato tanan hasta kapulisan o military, nga after the program, you can claim your cash at the Provincial Treasurer's Office, pinagi ni Treasurer Roy Salubre. You just present your ID to him after the program. Kini atong pagabuhaton karon ceremonial, so we'd like to ask the following to go to, up to the stage. Unahon nato ang atong PNP, Kapulisan sa Lalawigan, pinangulohan ni Colonel Engbert Soriano o ang iyang command group. We have a total of 2,609 personnel o ang total incentives alang sa kapulisan moabot o 13,045,000 pesos. Atong pagpakan si Colonel Soriano o ang iyang command group. Pagdawat nini, this is only ceremonial, ha? The actual cash at 5,000 each makuha sa tanan after the program wanto lang sa treasurer's office. Ang sunod nga mudawat mao ang atong kadakuan sa Regional Community Defense Group, pinanguluhan ni Colonel Edgar Mangabay. They have 99 personnel involved and the total amount for all of them is 495,000 pesos. Ang sunod nga makadawat mao ang atong kadakuan gikan sa 53rd Engineering Brigade, pinanguluhan ni Lieutenant Colonel Efrain Kamaganakan. They have 31 personnel and the total amount for all of them is 155,000 pesos. Another round of applause. Sunod nga makadawat mao ang atong kadakuan sa Task Force Cebu Bohol Siquijor, pinanguluhan ni Colonel Jerry Borja. They have 94 personnel o ang kinatibuk ang kantidad alang kanila 470,000 pesos. Ang sunod nga makadawat mao ang atong kadakuan labi na gayod ang mga linemen sa Visayan Electric Company Incorporated, pinanguluhan karon ni Engineer Mark Kendika, AVP for Engineering Operations. They have a total of 36 personnel o ang kinatibuk ang kantidad alang kanila 180,000 pesos. Ang sunod mao ang Sebeco 1, pinanguluhan ni Engineer Hitolio Crudua. They have a total of 165 personnel. Ug ang kinatibuk ang kantidad alang kanila 825,000 pesos. Sunod nga makadawat mao ang Sebeco 2. Pinanguluhan ni Engineer Lowell Belsinia. Aduna sila ay 213 ka personnel o linemen o ang kinatibuk ang kantidad alang sa Sebeco 2 1,065,000 pesos. Ang katapusan mao ang Sebeco 3, pinanguluhan ni General Manager Virgilio Fortich. They have a total of 166 linemen. O ang kinatibok ang kantidad alang kanila 830,000 pesos. So kung atong tutalon, we have a total of 3,413 personnel nga makadawat sa incentives o sa kantidad nga 5,000 pesos each, and the total amount for all of them 17,065,000 pesos. Daghan salamat. Once again, masipag pakpak alang kanilang tanan. Salamat Governor, salamat Board Members. Makabalik na sa atong tagsa-tagsa kalingkuranan. Again, I'd like to repeat the reminder nga human sa atong program karong udto ang actual nga kantidad alang sa matag usa 5,000 pesos makuha ninyo dito sa buhatan ni Provincial Treasurer Roy Salubre. Please just present your ID to him after the program. Nining panahuna, nining higayuna, maminaw kita og mga mensahe. Atong unahon pagpaminaw ang atong kugihan og ma-update nga Provincial Director sa Cebu Provincial Police Office, Colonel Engelbert Soriano.
Maimbuntag ka natong tanan. On behalf of the men and women of Cebu Police Provincial Office, I would like to express our deepest gratitude to the recognition, support, and generosity of the very hardworking, very generous, very dedicated, committed Governor of the Province of Cebu, Honorable Governor Gwendolyn F. Garcia, ma'am. And to all the board members who have supported the idea of giving this incentive to the police and to the armed forces and all the public servants of this province, Board Tata, Board Dong, Board Jerome, Board Jonky, Board Rasi, Board Sir Rubio. To all of you, thank you very much also. Sa aming pong partners, the Armed Forces of the Philippines led by Colonel Jerry Borja, sir, thank you for the efficient and very effective partnership. Working partnership. And of course, to our fellow public servants, we thank you also for the prompt and dedicated response to Typhoon Odette's relief operations, recovery, and rehabilitation. I've seen how our governor toured all the areas, and I just cannot avoid but admire the determination of our Honorable Governor to recover as early as possible. Ma'am, we assure you of our consistent support, and you may rely on your Philippine National Police. Thank you, thank you, thank you, and God bless everyone.
Thank you so much, Colonel Engelbert Soriano. Salamat. Lain nga nakahatag o dako kayong tampo alang sa atong recovery effort, mao ang atong mga sakop sa Regional Community Defense Group. Let us now listen to their head, Colonel Edgar Mangabay.
Mayong buntag sa atong tanan. In behalf of the Armed Forces of the Philippines here in the province of Cebu, both the active and the reserve, we would like to thank the provincial government of Cebu headed by the Governor, the Honorable Gwen Garcia, ma'am. Maraming salamat for this recognition and for the support, and also for giving us the opportunity to serve the people of Sibuman. Rest assured that the armed forces, your armed forces, is always here, ready and committed to serve the people of Cebu. Once again, sir, ma'am, sa ating lahat, maraming salamat at magandang umaga po sa ating lahat.
Thank you so much, Colonel Mangabay. Ang tulong ka si Beko, dako sa kayo og tampo alang sa atong recovery effort. Unahon nato pagpaminaw karon ang nangulo sa Cebeco 1, General Manager Gritulio Crodua.
Among pinalangga nga Governor Gwen, usa ra nang members of mga board members karon nga present and other officials sa government and other agencies sa ato ang mga isuon sa Cebecos and Visayan Electric and all others present here today mayong buntag ka natong tanan gob sa imong strong leadership nakapadugang sa among kadasig nga kami makakita makabarog pagbalik og dali sa ato ang probinsya sa Cebu aron mapasugan pagbalik nga ato ang mga kaigsuunan labi na sa ato ang area coverage sa pinakadali nga panahon gani karon padayon pata o paganita kahuman apan naa na ta sa mga kabaranggayan. So hopefully mahuman natag sa dili na madugay kay kita nangandoy gyud nga makabarog pagbalik sa mubo nga panahon. Daghang salamat nining maong recognition gob nga imong gihatag sa mga Warriors of Light nato dinhi sa Cebu. Mayong buntag kanatong tanan.
Daghang salamat GM Crodua for your message. Salamat. Ang sunod natong paminaon mao ang nangulo sa Cebeco 2, General Manager Lowell Belsinia.
Akong pagyukbo ato sa atong pinalanggang governor ug atong mga miyembro sa provincial board mayong buntag kanatong tanan. Sa ngalan sa kinatibuk ang banay sa Cebeco 2, among kinasingkasing nga pasalamat sa Cebu Provincial Board pinanguluhan sa atong maabtik o mapinanggaon nga Governor Gwendolyn Garcia sa iyang paghatag o recognition o incentives ngadto sa atong mga linemen nga mo'y atong gitawag nga Warriors of Light. So, pinaagi sa pagbulig sa provincial government na padali o pa-restore nato ang pagpasuga sa atong mga kabalayan ngadto sa hilit nga mga lugar sa barang sa tibuok probinsya sa Sugbo. So sa ngalan again sa among mga hunta direktiba usab sa management makawani sa Cebeco 2 among kinasingkasing gayud nga pasalamat ngadto kan sa Cebu Provincial Government gani latas sa katuigan ang provincial government kanunay gayud nga nagbulig kanamo sa Cebeco at Cebeco 2 for that matter sa unsang ka mga pangakuhan ilabi na gayud sa rural electrification program o gato sab sa atong mga partners dinhi sa atong pag-restore sa atong sugang nagitabnon ang atong PNP o atong igsuon usab nga buhat sa Cebeco. Daghan kaayong salamat again. Daghang salamat ug maayong buntag kanatong tanan.
Daghang salamat GM Belsinia. Ang sunod natong paminaon mao ang Cebeco 3, pinagi sa General Manager Virgilio Fortich.
mayong buntag natong tanan gob, mayong buntag. Tiunay nga pagpangga o pagpakabana ang nabati namo pinanguluhan sa ato ang numero unong gobernador garbo sa Sugbo, inubanan sa suporta pod sa provincial board. So kana amo lang gisuklian og serbisyo nga walay reservation sukad pa December 17 hangtod karon nagsige ang ato ang mga Warriors of Light sa pagtrabaho. Ang ako ganing gisulti sa atong mga kaubanan sa Sebeco 3. Kung kapuyon mo ang ilang tanaw sa mga trabaho uno, banig na. Kapuy na yun. Apan ako silang giingnan, ingon-aniyo na lang nato. Isipa nga si Governor Gwen, usa ka vitamins o energy drink nga makadasig, makahatag, dugang, kusog, panlimbasog sa matag. Usa mao na nga mapasigarbuhon ko nga mo pahibaw kaninyo, kaninyo gob nga daw magic ang gibuhat nato as far as Sebeco 3 is concerned, Sebeco 1, 2, and 3, and Veco. Nagsigi kong tanaw sa numbers as to restoration progress or accomplishments sa mga provinces nga affected. No? Kunya akong gi-compare ang mga distribution utilities. So layinin yung tanaw, inyong makita unsa ang difference in terms of progress, in terms of accomplishments. Taas yung kaayo ang ato ang nabuhat. No? We made actually the impossible possible. Kanang tanan, dili na mo maangkon kung wala ang pagdasig, ang matang sa pagpangulo, pagdumala, nga gipakita sa ato ang gobernadora. O na nga kami mapasalamaton. Sa ngalan sa Sebeco 3, Tibok Banay sa Sebeco 3, pinanguluhan sa atong Hunta Direktiba ni Director President, Director Silito Bardinas, ang management staff o tanang mga kawani sa Sebeco 3, salamat kaayo ni ining tanan gob, salamat kaayo ni ining tanan provincial board o kanatong tanan, salamat kaayo sa isig suporta.
Salamat kaayo, GM Fortich. Alay na itong paminaon karon, mausap ang Visayan Electric Company. Sa ngalan sa Presidente ni Engineer Raul Lucero, atong paminaon, ang Assistant Vice President for Engineering Operations, Engineer Mark Kendika.
Gov. Gwen, o sa itong mga distinguished guests, maing buntag sa tanan. On behalf of our management and our linemen and the men and women who endeavor nga mapasiga na tatanan o usasad nga naapektuhan sa Typhoon Odette and we will continue to serve our customers. Ako, in behalf of them, we would like to express our deepest gratitude, our deepest appreciation for the support and the assistance given to us by the good governor, Gov. Gwen, and the provincial government. Daghan kayong salamat sa suporta o sa tanan public servants o among isuon mga utilities sa Sebeco 1, 2, and 3. Daghan kayong salamat sa suporta o sa tabang. Thank you and may buntag.
Salamat kayo, Engineer Mark Kendika. Salamat. Inihigayon na o sarili pa nato mabati ang mensahe sa atong gobernador. Ato siyang gihangyo, pagsakang ato sa stage, alang nining gitawag o New Year's Call. New Year's Call is an annual tradition borrowed from the military where officers call on the head of the LGU, in particular Governor Gwen Garcia, to give thanks for the organization's accomplishment from the previous year. It is also one of the cherished traditions in the PNP organization to reflect upon the events of the past and to welcome the opportunities of the new year. The PNP adopts this tradition to serve as an inspiration for its officers in aiming the organization's goals and objectives for the new year, and to present their token of appreciation to the governor. Umani ang New Year's call, ang salute to the governor, to be led by Colonel Engelbert Soriano together with the command group of the PNP Cebu Province. Inihigayo na ang atong gobernador paghatagan og matahong kayong token gikan sa atong kapulisan sa lalawigan. A big hand please, a beautiful picture frame and kining bouquet of flowers alang kaniya. Lain masipang pakpak, alang kang Gobernador Juan Garcia. Thank you, nakabalik na ta sa atong lingkuranan. And once again, thank you to Colonel Soriano and the command group. And all the men and women in uniform sa atong kapulisan. Salamat. Nini kayo na, ato ng paminaon ang mensahe sa labing unang babaeng gobernador ng atong lalawigan, siya ang top performing governor nationwide. Ubos sa iyang liderato, Cebu is the best. Gobernador Gwen Garcia.
Please take your seats. Thank you very much. Our provincial board members, special mention our chairman for the Committee on Peace and Order, Board Member Jonky Uwano. The provincial director of the Cebu Provincial Police Office, Colonel Engelbert Soriano. Representing the 53rd Engineering Brigade, Lieutenant Colonel Ephraim Kamaganakan, Colonel Edgar Mangabay of the RSCOM, Engineer Mark Kendika, AVP for Engineering Operations BECO, and our three GMs of CEBECOS 1, 2, and 3, Engineer Etulio Cordua, Engineer Lowell Belsinia, and Engineer Virgilio Fortich. The men and women in uniform, our distinguished guests, and our linemen, maayong buntag kanatong tanan. It's a month and 8 days since Typhoon Odette first struck and devastated a huge expanse of the province of Cebu. And looking at us now, I think most would agree we have come a long way. Since that very first Saturday when we met here at the gallery, at the other room, as we grappled with a multitude of problems that beset us in the aftermath of that super typhoon. Nagkakuyog ta, PNP, ang AFP, ang atong DUs o gipangitaan natong paagi unsay angay unang buhaton, unsay atong direksyon. Because if we were at that point in time to endeavor to solve all of the problems that beset us, perhaps we would still be as confused and as aimless, as headless chicken running around in circles. But we decided to take matters into our own hands. Nobody promised us a perfect life anyway. You know, as that song goes, I beg your pardon, I never promised you a rose garden. And so we decided to take the major, major challenges that we faced with a fortitude, resiliency, and indomitable spirit that Cebuanos are known for. And we defined our course. First and foremost was clearing the major thoroughways. For how could relief operations reach our far-flung barangays and even our LGUs if the roads were impassable. And so we called on our contractors and of course the PNP and the AFP to help us. To help us as we grappled with fallen trees, fallen poles, and even parts of houses' roofs that littered and cluttered our roads. I called on our DUs to give us an idea on how and when power could possibly be restored. And I discovered that it really needed a concerted effort between NGCP, VECO, and the three SEBECOs. Commitments were given on that very Saturday that parts of the city and parts of the province would be lighted up within the week. And those commitments were followed through. Thank you, VECO and SEBECOs 1, 2, and 3, for keeping true to your commitments. You gave us timelines on when even highways could first be lighted up and when the different households in your respective franchises would be fully energized. And as GM Portich has rightfully said so, you have performed beyond expectations, well beyond performances of other DUs in the other provinces that were not as badly hit as the province of Cebu. Even SEBECO 1, with over 5,000 poles. Yeah, honestly, that's true. 5,000 poles. Nakurat mangod si Board Rasi. Continues to now restore power. All of the 18 LGUs under its franchise have been fully energized within 3 weeks along the highways and poblacion, while other interior barangays continue to be worked at. As SEBECOs 2 and 3 now assist SEBECO 1. Our clearing operations, we were able to establish and to complete within a record number of days because the armed forces, aided by our ARESCOM, the 53rd Engineering Brigade, and of course, the Cebu Bohol Sikihor Task Force, were all there. The personnel helping our contractors to pick up debris and to clear the roads that were previously impassable. So daghan kaayong salamat kaninyo atong mga giila nga kauban niining atong paningkamot nga makabarug ug usab ang Sugbo. Even as we continue with our rebuilding and recovery efforts, we face, as we continue to face this challenge of the omnipresent COVID-19 and the newest version, the newest model, you know, like cars, you have new models. The newest model is Omicron. And I would like to thank our PNP, headed by Colonel Engelbert Soriano, for having stayed with us in the strict monitoring of public transport that tend to overload, in the strict monitoring of passengers that need to maintain health protocols, and in seeing to it that in the province of Cebu, EO 35 and 35B is strictly enforced. Daghan kaayong salamat kaninyo atong mga kauban sa kapulisan sa inyong makanunayon nga pagtabang. Why did I decide to give this incentive? More than saying, more than expressing words of gratitude, it is really also in recognition of the fact that our linemen, our PNP, because you are situated right here, though you may have prioritized your duties in re-energization, in restoring power to our houses and our barangays and our public buildings, in monitoring the public transport and maintaining peace and order, kamo sad, apektado sad mo, apektado sad ang atong mga kaigsuunan. Apan giuna usa pag-atiman ang gikinahanglan sa publiko kaysa ilang kaugalingong pribadong panginahanglan. Pila kaha ninyo nga nalupad pod ang atop, nangaguba ang mga balay. Doon na manggali usa ka pulis karon nga at the height of Typhoon Odette, met this accident, now I met him, a police officer, natangtangan in tawag tudlo. But such is the nature of public service, to rise above one's own public private interest. No matter how one may feel, no matter what emotions may be kept inside our hearts, first and foremost, because we have sworn to serve, it has to be duty above all. Ugmao ka na ang inyong gipakita. Allow the Cebu Provincial Government to say thank you for your dedication and commitment to duty, but also to say, we recognize that each of you have your families and your own needs. And we hope that this cash incentive will, in our own small way, alleviate a little the burden that each of you, with your own individual stories, must bear. So, busa, gikan sa kinahiladman, sa kasing-kasing, sa usa nga kauban ninyo sa pagserbisyo sa publiko, si Gwen Garcia, dawata ang akong kinasing-kasing nga pasalamat ug sa kanunay atong ipatigbabaw kining mga pulong sa usa kaawit nga nahimo na karon nga daw labaw nga naka pakita kung unsa ang Suboanon. Kaninga awit, ang mabuhi ka, Suboanon, o ang mga pulong nagkanayon, pagkadaghana, nagiagian ta, mga pagsulay, kasakitan pa, kay ligdong kaman, o may baruganan, gipasidunggan mo pagkasubuanon ta. Mabuhi ang Subo, mabuhi kitang tanang Subuanon. Daghan kaayong salamat.
Dagan salamat, Gobernador Gwen Garcia. Og dinhi mapupos ang atong tulumanon karong buntaga, aduna tay lunch buffet alang sa tanan. And again, ang atong mga linemen, kapulisan og military can claim your incentives at 5,000 pesos each dito sa buhatan ni Provincial Treasurer Roy Salubre sa Silom after the program. Ano dinhira sa atong social hall? O sa second floor nining atong Capitol Social Hall. Magsugod na ang atong panioto. We are inviting everyone to proceed to the buffet station at the back portion of the social hall and get your food. Samtang ang presidential table hatagan sa ilang kaugalingong pagkaon. Enjoy your lunch.